For the simply supported beam subjected to a distributed load, draw the shear and bending moment diagrams. This is the second example for the shear and bending moment diagrams main video. The link to that video and other examples are in the description below. Just like in the previous example, the first thing we need to find are the reaction forces at A and C. With a free body diagram, we see that we can substitute the distributed load that adds up to 3 kN by a point load of 3 kN right between B and C. By doing this, we can do a sum of moments about A to find Cy, and then a sum of forces in Y to solve for Ay. The shear diagram with an x-axis in meters and a y-axis in kilonewtons would go up by 0.75 at A, maintain that value till B, and have a slope of minus 1.5 for 2 meters till it reaches C. The slope of 1.5 for 2 meters would yield a rise value of minus 3 that, starting from 0.75, results in minus 2.25. At C, we would find the reaction force Cy that goes up by 2.25. For the bending moment diagram, with an x-axis in meters and a y-axis in kilonewton meters, would begin at 0 since there are no reaction or external couples at A, move upward with a slope of 0.75 for 2 meters, which means it goes up by 1.5, and from B to C, we see that at B, there's the same slope of 0.75, then a slope of 0, and from there to C, the slope goes from 0 to a value of minus 2.25. Connecting the slopes, we find the overall shape of the bending moment diagram, and to find the maximum moment, we can add the area under the curve between B and the slope of 0 to the 1.5 value the moment had at B. To make sure that the moment diagram does indeed end at 0, we can also calculate the area under the curve between the point of 0 slope and C. Since this area is negative, this is the value we would subtract from the maximum moment to get to C. This means that the bending moment diagram does indeed end at 0. For more examples on shear and bending moment diagrams, make sure to check out the links in the description below. Thanks for watching!